Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 Developer Beta 6 and Public Beta 5 have been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone XS Max as my main device, and I've also been using iPadOS, the same developer and public betas, on my iPad from 2018. It's the iPad Pro 12.9. So we're going to talk about this, about my experience and then your experience based off the YouTube community poll. And then also we'll take a look at some of your comments. But before we start any of that, I want to talk about a couple different features and things that I missed with the update video. Now, also, if you'd like to see exactly what I'm talking about and when, check the description as I've left the time codes there so you can just jump to the part of the video you want to see. Now, one of the updates I actually forgot to mention with the iOS update video I did was if you go into Safari and then you 3D press or haptic press on a link, you can actually hide the link preview. So you'll see I can press it again and hide the preview, go over to this one, show the preview. So if we 3D press, it shows the actual link previews on an app by app basis. So this is really nice. Just hide it and it only shows the URL now instead of the entire link preview. So this could be great for security for some people, or if you just don't like it in general. Now, Siri announcements are now missing in this particular update. So if you were using Siri announcements, you go to Siri and search, there was a Siri announcement spot where you could actually use that with your AirPods. That's gone now. So that's missing. And then there's one more thing. I don't know if I've seen anybody talk about this, but it's actually under privacy. Then it's under location services. Then all the way down at the bottom under system services, there's a new thing called system customization. So you'll see right here, there's system customization. What that means specifically, I don't really know. We don't know what system customization is, but it's under system services. So that's new as well. And that's, I think, everything that's significant anyway that I missed. And let's talk about how the actual experience has been for me, because it's been better for me than Beta 5. Beta 5 was actually really bad for me. However, based off the YouTube community poll, it went back and forth depending on what phone you're using and maybe what apps you have installed. Some people said it was better than Beta 5. Some people said it was worse. My major issue that I have is if I leave, say maybe I leave my house or leave any place that I'm connected to Wi-Fi with, all of a sudden Wi-Fi will drop, of course, because I don't have it anymore, but then I'll lose internet connectivity completely until I turn on airplane mode and turn it back off. This has been happening over the past few days and I've tried rebooting everything. It just continually happens. So it's really annoying. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about it right now, but that's what's happening. So if I leave, I almost switched to a different device that wasn't running the beta because of it, because it's pretty annoying. I could go to YouTube or any app, music included, and it will just say no internet connection. So that's kind of annoying. Now, as far as voice to text, when I use that, which is something I use quite often, I actually find that it's not very accurate. So if I'm talking to it, it's not accurate at all. In fact, let's see. What's the weather today and tomorrow?
Looks like nice weather coming up today.
So it's actually working this time, but for some reason, sometimes it's really bad and other times it's okay. It just seems worse to me overall. I get a lot more mistakes this time around. I don't know what that is. Also, people have asked me how RAM management is, and RAM management is basically how long an app can stay open in the background. So one of these apps without reloading, it seems to be not so great this time around. In fact, maybe I could open a couple apps and then YouTube might completely reload. I don't know if that's an issue with YouTube and them not updating it for iOS 13 or something else at this point, but right now I'd say it's not great. Also, I keep losing touch responsiveness on my iPad. So if you use one of these iPads and sometimes you're touching like this or just moving, sometimes it doesn't respond and I actually have to turn it off like this, turn it back on, unlock it, and then it will work again. I keep having this bug. I don't have that on the iPhone. I only have it on the iPad and I find it to be really annoying. Hopefully they work that out. It has gotten better, but it's still not great. Also, mail is a huge problem still. In fact, the stock mail app, I use it on the iPad because I don't use mail on my iPad that much other than Gmail. But I switch back to Spark on my iPhone because it's almost unusable. Sometimes email doesn't load, the conversations don't show up, sometimes search isn't working right. There's just too many issues for me to use it full time, so I'll use Spark or maybe some other until that's fixed, which I'm sure it'll be fixed by the time the actual full version is released to the public. And then as far as apps are concerned, I haven't really had any issues except for the Center app here. I was trying that out. It seemed to crash over and over. It's the only app I've had issues with it crashing. Other people have said they've had apps crash though. Performance has actually been quite good. I've had no issues. Scrolling is nice and fast. If I go into settings and scroll, go back and forth, it doesn't really matter. I can just go back and forth quickly with no issues. Opening apps, nothing really seems to be very slow. So everything's quite good on the performance side. And most of you actually said the same thing. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, let's go down to battery here. And battery health for me is 100%. This is a little bit newer device, but I only show you that to tell you I have the best case scenario as far as overall battery life. So hopefully yours is similar, 99%. I would expect that to actually creep down to 99 soon. But screen on time, 5 hours and 30 minutes. Screen off time, 1 hour and 29 minutes. Then I switched mail a couple days ago, and I got terrible battery life, 3 hours and 37 minutes, 32 minutes of screen off time. So just depending on how you use it is going to really make a big difference. But at the end of the day, 20 or 30% battery life left with those screen on times. So that one's really poor, but I would say 6.5 hours of screen on time is probably reasonable with a XS Max at this point. It could be a lot better. I know a lot of you said it was much better. Now let's talk about your overall experience, because many of you said that one of your major complaints was that wallpaper was no longer dimming with night mode. So if you switch to dark mode or night mode, dark mode here, the wallpaper was no longer getting darker. And that's true. I think they turned that feature off. Hopefully they bring it back because it was a nice feature. Also, many people were saying watchOS battery life is much better now, especially if you're not on the beta and you're on watch beta or watchOS 5 instead of the beta. They were saying battery life has returned to normal. So that's really good news. I don't know what happened with the previous beta, but now it's working well. Most people had decent experiences with the beta. Some people had really good and some people had really poor experiences. But let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. As you can see, almost 10,000 people voted. So I really appreciate that. I think everyone here appreciates the feedback. It gives us a great idea of how it's been for everyone overall. So 9.8K votes there. 33% of you said it was great. 3% said terrible. That's the same as the previous beta. So that's actually a good sign. 18% said okay, but some bugs. 35% of you are on a previous version, 12.4 or older, and 12% of you use Android. Now, this particular comment section is 217 comments. I've read every single one of them, and most people, other than small bugs like Chromecast not working, which may be a major thing for you, most of the time it's working okay, and it's getting closer to the final release, but right now, it still may not be usable depending on what you're doing. So let's take a look at the comments. Performance and battery life has been decent on my iPhone XR and have had no problems compared to the previous beta being public beta 4 for me. So that's a good sign. I'm on iPhone XS. Everything seems to be smooth and fast. No excessive drain on iOS 5 watch. Dark mode has a few problems. Doesn't SIM wallpaper, nothing serious. Battery life is really good on an iPhone SE. Running beta 6 on my iPhone 8 Plus, it's been okay so far. On iPhone 8 Plus, the Mail app won't sync Gmail and Outlook. Like I said, there's a lot of issues with that Mail app right now. It's been running good, no resprings, performance is great. My iPhone did lock up on me once when going into the home screen from the lock screen. Other than that, it's been really good. iPhone XS, no problem on my iPhone SE. This is something I saw on quite a few of them. Siri is having an issue when you say the word hey in front of them. It's having serious issues. I have to speak very loudly to invoke it using iPhone SE on Dev Beta 6. Battery life is terrible. Performance is amazing though. Best part is that apps open fast comparatively to previous Beta 4 on my iPhone 7 Plus. This is a bug that someone was telling me about and I talked to them a little bit on the side about. iMessage still wants to use email instead of phone number. They even checked the settings and it's set only to use the phone number, but it keeps using email, so that's kind of strange. iPhone X, and it's great performance-wise. Perfect on my iPhone XR. Here's someone with really poor battery on their iPad 6. New email showing up blank, force close and reopen fixes it. iPhone X, public beta 5, Apple Mail exchange account. Shortcuts don't work through CarPlay, and then has some issues manually hitting in shortcuts when connected through CarPlay, then set up to map out in destinations and shuffle playlist. Starts playlist, then stops. Battery life on my iPad Pro 12.9 2018 is terrible. I forgot to mention that with this iPad Pro, it's not great either. Probably 6 hours, where it should be getting closer to 10. 3D Touch is working good now. What do you think about that? I really think it works fine, quite honestly. Some of the animations are not the same, but it seems to be more pressure sensitive than it was before. All is well so far on my iPhone 8. Downloaded on my iPad, and once again the Mail app is very buggy. I've submitted multiple feedback reports. Hopefully this is fixed before the final. I would say it probably will be, and the reason I say that is because Apple uses the same Mail app, so I'm sure they're experiencing the same thing. iOS Beta 6, I'm on iPhone XS Max, and it lags and sometimes freezes in settings or in an app, even on the home screen. I would try rebooting that. I don't see that too often. Let's read a couple more. iPhone 7, buggy. Using iPhone 8 Plus, overall very good. Battery life is excellent. Only issue is still with the stock Mail app, where occasionally some emails don't load. Have to close out of the app completely and reopen it and have the odd respring. All in all, I'd give this beta an 8 out of 10. And like I said, that's what I see over and over. There's issues with that Mail app. iPhone 7, running smooth and good battery life. There's this three-finger gesture that's really annoying if you use your three fingers to touch the screen or while playing any mobile games. There's this copy and paste. That's actually a feature now that's undo and redo. Swipe three fingers left and right. One is undo, one is redo. It's just a better way to do that instead of shaking your phone to undo. So I don't know of any way to disable that. It could be in the settings at some point, though. And then the final one, iPhone 6S Plus battery has been really inconsistent. So that's it for all of the experiences with Beta 6. I would love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. Do you agree with most of these people? Are you having the same experience as me on a XS Max? It's been pretty good for me, quite honestly, other than that LTE issue, which is quite bad, actually, in my opinion. It's something that I obviously need to have connectivity, and it just keeps coming back over and over. So that part really annoys me. Other than that, I'd say it's good overall. I would expect a new beta this coming week, maybe on Wednesday again, since it seems to be we're on a week-to-week basis again. But you never know with Apple. They could push that off a little bit. But hopefully it gets even better and better. And then a final release in mid-September. But if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course I'll link it in the description, as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.